Well, we have some very sad news to show to all of you, which is that the hedge fund Melvin Capital is officially down 53% in the month of January as part of the GameStop bet. As some Redditors are saying, only 47% left to go in terms of how much damage they have left to inflict. But this is just, again, shows you the titanic amounts of money that were put behind the GameStop short and just how greedy they got, Krystal. They never could have suffered such a massive blow like this if they had not been not just greedy, like Wall Street greedy, like outrageously beyond the pale, beyond even what is of the norm on Wall Street. And then all it took was one guy on a Reddit forum being like, hey, I don't think GameStop's going bankrupt in the next 2 years, which shows you that this short that they have on the stock is completely ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, these hedge funds and others put together shorting 140% of the stock speaks to your point of not just greed, but an outrageous and insane level of greed. And 99% of the time, that greed ultimately pays off, right? Last year, while you were starving out there and struggling and worried about paying your rent, worried about your job, all of those things in the midst of a once in a century style pandemic, hedge funders were having their best year in a decade. The top 20 hedge funds, according to the numbers from Matt Taibbi, had the best year and most profitable year in a decade. Mm-hmm. So yeah, at the core, I mean, there's a lot of different motivations going on at the core of like the whole GameStop situation, but at the core, it's a deep desire to make these people feel just a tiny bit of pain, to flip the table for once, have the people score a blow against these elites who have sucked up, not just in the pandemic, but over decades, who have essentially sucked up all of the wealth and opportunity in society. On the political front, of course, you had lots of politicians waiting in to get on the record that they're for the people, and people like Ted Cruz, who are part of, you know, constructing and totally, totally like, you know, bootlickers to the type of funders and Wall Streeters that, you know, that this whole thing is aimed at. But Elizabeth Warren actually took what was kind of a surprising and strange position on all of this. Of course, Warren came up as a critic of Wall Street and, you know, like excesses and speculation in the market, and as really a consumer advocate, knows a lot about these things. And she's taking kind of like a weird both sidesy position in this whole thing, saying essentially like, well, we don't really know what's going on, so we better have an investigation. Let's take a listen to what she had to say.
Well, let's start with the fact that we actually don't know who all the players are in this, whether or not there's big money on both sides. And that's why it is that we need an SEC investigation. But understand, what's happening with GameStop is just a reminder of what's been going on Wall Street now for years and years and years. It's a rigged game. And it's been a set of players who come in and manipulate the market. They've turned this stock market not into a place where you get capital formation to support businesses, but more into a casino. And they've been doing all kinds of market manipulation, pump and dump, companies that buy back shares of their own stock so that they can inflate the stock prices. We need a market that is transparent, that's level, and that is open to individual investors. It's time for the SEC to get off their duffs and do their jobs.
I mean, I feel like a little bit of her like capitalist to her bones or whatever her quote is showing there, because she's still paying homage to this idea that like the idealized version of the stock market is just about like fundamental value, et cetera. And it's like, the whole thing is just a casino and fake ultimately. So on the one hand, she says some of the right things about, you know, I'd certainly be open to like an investigation into the hedge funders and that side of things, and additional regulation on that side. As I said earlier, I think hedge funds should just be abolished flat out. They're like an accident of history to start with. But she comes at this from this weird, both sides might be wrong and we don't really know what's going on. That is kind of a strange positioning, ultimately.
That's how it's just tonally is so weird. And look, she's not wrong. We don't know whether it's big sides of money on either side of the trade. And, you know, look, that's definitely bearing an investigation. But it just sounds like she's trying to crack down on the Redditors themselves. And I'm like, that's not the story and the takeaway here. So one, it reveals like terrible political positioning. And second is it's just odd in that we don't really understand her framing or exactly what she's calling for. And that's why I just thought it was so weird in order to see her and other like Massachusetts regulators try to fall on the side of GameStop, especially when they know, like we know that more institutional pressure against the Redditors would definitely come to the benefit of people like Melvin Capital, that if there's going to be any solution that does crack down on wild speculation, which look, I would be totally for, then it has to start at the very top with people like the hedge funds and Melvin Capital in the beginning.
Yeah, I think that's right. So we'll see where all of this goes. My guess is we're going to have a bunch of grandstanding from politicians who want to decide themselves on the right side of a populist issue, but not actually really change anything.
Yeah, that's exactly correct. All right, guys, if weather permits, we'll be back in the studio tomorrow. It's been great hosting the show remotely, and we will see you all tomorrow.
Have a good one, guys.